Hello everyone and welcome back to Crusader Kings III, part 17. One by one, they will fall. And now we are in control of King Louis IV of France, which is the child of King Manasses of France, and which in turn is the child of King Louis III. So basically we've jumped a generation here to be called Louis IV. We have a lot to do, and as you can guess by the title, these includes taking counties one by one. And we're gonna do this slowly, we're gonna take our time, there's nothing that really puts us in a hurry. And we're gonna start with Provins, the barony of Provins. And then while we're in truce with him, then we're going to get Upper Burgundy here. And then while we're in truce with him, we'll get some of Wessex. And then, we'll shift around like this between these trees. And that's what we'll do. So, let's do that. Prince Carloman, he wants a position on the kingdom. He's got nothing really going for him, so he's not going to get anything. Duke Amelin of Burgundy, he's got 23 diplomacy. This guy is a nobody. I mean, other than being my cousin, he's a nobody. He's got a lot of claims, but he doesn't have any army or anything. So we will actually put my important minister there, Duke Amelin. Ambitious high tax, yeah. So we'll put Duke Amelin here. There you go. We might modify his contract as well. He does have high tax. That's not good for him. Let's put it down to normal. There you go. Then Prince Robert expects a position as well, but he's not good at much of anything. So, I mean, unfortunately, he's going to have to have nothing, and he's the youngest of ours. So he's 30. I'm 35. Oh, he's not that young, actually, when you think of that. But yeah, he will get nothing. I could create the Kingdom of Brittany. Really? Okay. Anyway, or the Duchy of Bar. What else could I do? Not much. I am going to make some money and try to see if we can't vassalize this dude instead. And I think we will be able to. We just need to, for him to grow up. So let's start the game. We've got a lot of ransom. Let's take a look at these members. Liberty faction. Some of these are in prison, so we're definitely not going to release them. They are forbidden to join faction until October 1003. But still, we're not going to give them any chance to do so. Yes, let's go check. Tiny help penalty? No thanks. Let's go check on maybe getting back our stuff from Prince Robert. Artifact. I guess I can't ask it for him. He doesn't have it. Who has it? Prince Carloman, maybe? Oh well, doesn't matter. All right, let's make money. After long thinking, I finally decided to invite Prince Robert to come on a tour of one of my estates. Oh well, there you go. Now he's our friend. There you go. And that's gonna stop this faction. Let's have Prince Carloman as our friend as well. There you go. Befriend. Oh, he's already my friend, so that's why he's not in there. And this guy is underage, but can I make him my friend? No, because he's a child. Let's get this dude to become our friend. There you go. And now, oops, I forgot to put some volume for the game. There you go. Alright, so now everyone is our friends, or soon to be. The money is getting in the bank. Oh, that's fine. He actually likes me pretty much. Let's ransom him, actually. Oh boy. For a favor? Yeah, let's ransom him anyway. Now he likes me less because he doesn't have a seat on the council. Let's see what we can do for him. Mayor, she's not a big threat, actually. We could put Duke Geoffroy there. And if that makes him happy, then there you go, right? And maybe we could modify his contract, put normal taxes, there you go. Now, the important thing is I want people to like me, even if I don't like them. Okay, greetings, King Louis of France. I have prowled through documents both ancient and of less certain provenance. I finally have enough material to make the case that you are the rightful lord of the county of Provence. All that is missing is one little bribe, so I will lose 84. And there you go. I'm gonna declare war. Oh shit, I can just... Okay, wait, my claim? De jure? Yeah, my claims, there you go. Thank you. Raise the armies! The men at war, at least, because otherwise I don't care for peasants. He doesn't look like he has... Oh yeah, he has one ally. That is fine. Okay, no. I'm at maximum men at harm. And there you go. Let's go here. Here, actually. Let's go here. I don't know who these guys are, but... Bye-bye. Okay, wait a second. I've captured someone here? Oh, yes. I captured the war leader. There you go. Bye. Thank you very much for your lands. Actually, they're mine. You know, basically. Close family or confident? Each friend gains less stress. Let's go with family. Because right now, I do have families that wants the kingdom. My heir is unmarried. Oop. Prince Louis of France, 16 years old, 19 diplomacy. Very good, Louis. Let's go for a genius wife, if we can. 5 years old, 45. He's already a genius. Let's check for some of all skills. Here we have pretty, Cynic, Mac Hamlet. She's 29. She's Gaelic as well. I don't think we want that. There's a lot of pretties. Amazonian. Wow. Huge health boost. Well, she's 40 years old already. All right. Well, let's go for pretty. Let's just round them all up. And let's go by age. I am 16. How is she pretty? She's got a mask on. She's disfigured, but she's pretty. I don't get it. I guess they don't go by just the face. Okay. Generous, brave. Fearless lackey. She's bossy. Impatient. Diligent. Temperate. Yeah, I think this could be good here. She's got 20 diplomacy too. Oh boy, yes. She's a Polabian, so it's a foreign culture, but she's just a wife, right? It doesn't really matter that much. Let's get her in. There you go. Louis comes of age. There you go. 19, 12, 11, 8, 9. That's pretty good. He's gluttonous, though. That's pretty bad. But let's see what we can do of that. Let's put our council here to fabricate claims in Bayeux, is what I actually want. We'll not accept. Let's give him money. Now he likes us. Still a little bit. Let's actually... Are we swaying someone right now? We're not. So let's sway him. Befriend, actually. That's gonna help a lot. Alright. Baronies are still building. I'm gonna get, I think I'm... You know, I do have a lot of money coming in, and I'm thinking now could be the time to build up some men at harm bonuses. I just wonder, is this effective for the whole kingdom or just for people of this county, is what I'm wondering. Skirmishers, archers, heavy infantry, spearmen, light cavalry. What do we want, first of all? Because what I'm thinking is we'll just concentrate on, you know, one or the other. Because some of these don't have a lot of, like this, we only got two slots open now. So we're gonna have to either take barracks or military camps, or, you know, barracks and hunting ground. Hunting ground gets light cavalry damage and pursuit advantage. Barracks gets heavy infantry and spearmen. And as these guys, military camp gets archers and skirmishers. So these guys are a counter to spearmen. I think we're going to go with armored footmen. Where are they? Heavy infantry. There you go. So... Wooden barracks. To house levies as they ready for war, they need at least a roof over their head. These simple wooden barracks, thrown together in a hurry by willing carpenters and woodsmen, offer decent protection from the elements. Well, unless it rains. Alright, well, let's get it done. And then I think we're gonna get spearmen and what else I said we had? Heavy infantry, spearmen, archers, and skirmishers. I think these are gonna be, because these have 1, 2, 3, 4 bonuses, and it's just gonna have our light cavalry not having any bonuses. But you know, the light cavalry, we could get some bonuses somewhere else, I guess. Alright, let's get some money. Interpreting my recent friendliness as a sign, Dauphin Guichard has come to me with concern for one of my prisoners. Would please me greatly if you were to release my acquaintance. Alright, alright. I think with that, there you go, he's going to accept. But let's see if we can get him to accept normal feudal by befriending him. Oh, Duke Baudouin of Wessex. We'll get right back to him. As we will get this guy first. Escape, Count Baudouin. Curse you, Baudouin! But actually, I don't care that much. Let's actually release everyone for money. Only two of them can be ransomed for money. Age, do I have 11 for your 11 months? No, I don't have any child in here. There you go. We have a little bit of money now. Versailles. Oh, manor houses. That's a good one. That's good for taxes. Let's build manor houses. I think I do have them in Paris as well. Yeah. Okay. Vassalize. I can't, not even for normal. Okay, let's vassalize like this. And we'll vassalize this guy as well here. There you go. We'll get our countries back. Nice. There you go. Now I don't even need to do that with my council. So forget about that. And actually, maybe you could actually go. Yeah, just relation. Maybe we could try to get the County of Burgundy. Ah, Bourbon. There you go. Well, next claim we do have actually the de jure county, so we'll go for it. We just need to wait for the truce. And, oh, there you go. Let's increase size to 5 as soon as we get the money for it, which is right about now. Betrothed Kim Mary. There you go. Let's. Yeah, there you go. All right, things are doing are going pretty well under King Louis IV. We've lost this bit here, but this doesn't really matter that much. Now, we could get Duke Baudouin claim on the Duchy of Kent here. Who is Duke Baudouin? This guy. Duke Ebon. He likes me. I can't do that. Offer vassalage. Let's wait. Let's become friends. He'll get around. And we'll, I think we could even do so with all of England, or at least a part of it. Alright, a child of my dynasty, Prince Louis. His father is me. Okay, that's my heir. So he's got one child. It's going to be obviously Louis. So there you go. County corrupt. Lack of sheriffs. Oh, that sucks. Low control. Why is that? Who's in charge of control around here? The marshal? Yeah. Okay, let's go there. Alright, I've definitely built everything I could in here. Maybe I could start building some temples, you know? Not in Beaumont. This is not mine anymore. Prince Robert. There's already a temple here. Alright, whatever. Let's advance time here. Get some money. Get some buildings. This is hopeless. Really? Fuck. Alright, let's send him a gift. There you go! Now he likes me. Offer vassalage. There you go. With money, you can gain anything. There you go, France. So, we're gonna get confident here. Each friend has less stress. That's fine. I don't have much stress. But anyway. Next is gonna be Somerset. We're gonna send her money as well. And I guess we could try to scheme our way like this, politically captured everything we can in the kingdom here. We are in 1001. Council positions just open up. Prince Louis, Duke Ebon. Duke Ebon would probably... Well, Prince Louis has 26 diplomacy. There you go. We'll put him in domestic affairs. He's going to be good for that. It's going to prepare him as well for when I die and he's going to be king. No, nothing interesting here. Well, I guess, you know, I could get this right away. Nope, that is not interesting. We could start doing holy wars. But right now I can't do these guys, so I'm not. Just this is not good reason enough. Just that is not good either. Oh shit. Countess Mutazin, but she would be independent, right? Yeah, so no. No, not worth it. We're not gonna declare war to anyone. There's no faction. People are happy. Duke Amaury, there you go. That's gonna, he's gonna be happy about that here. I think since she's a child, I wouldn't be able to. Is that it? No, but she is a claimant on the Kingdom of France from Prince Manasses of France, actually. Prince Manasses, yeah. He owned that. He died. Now she's got a claim. But we're gonna vassalize. Send her money. And vassalize her. There you go. Barely. Thank you. I'm gonna transfer her to Duke Baudouin. Nah, he really likes me. Let's go, do we have people? Court physician. Everyone would suck at that, so we're not gonna put anyone. Excellent. Countess Isabel. Alright. Master of the horse, then we need master of the hunt. Not her again. There you go. Seneca. Magdalena, it's the only choice we have. Cupbearer, no one. Court jester, nah. There you go. Cornwall. East Anglia. Offer vassalage. We could try to get these guys into our pocket. Typhus, my poor wife. Oh. She's 42, a genius. It is time to decide how to treat Stephanie. I would recommend drastic measures, but the choice is yours, my lord. Alright, well, the time has come for drastic measures. Queen Stephanie gained greatly reduced disease symptom for a year. Nice. Available dynasty legacy. That's always also good. I wanted, I talked about that before in the past, but I wanted kin to go with blood. But then we weren't the dynasty head for a bit, and the AI chose like these two, so then I went for this. So I guess I'm gonna keep going for, you know, these two, and then we'll go for kin. Vassal limit plus 10, short rank duration minus 20%. Vassals are less likely to join claimant factions and liberty factions because we unlock the assertive rulers. So that is, you know, that is pretty good as well in itself. And what else? If you missed it, we establish a new tradition. It's going to take effect in 15 years, but basically only the strong. So the culture places a strong emphasis on having a few well-trained warriors. If you're not the best of the best, you're not welcome to serve. So number of knight plus 2, knight effectiveness plus 100%. And I think that's going to go good. Who is that? Alright, well, whatever. And I think that's going to be going good with our quest here to build some stuff for... for our knights. Here we're going to start building some... Oh, we don't have enough money. Okay. Good. Good, good. My wife has recovered. Duke Baudouin is gonna be happy to be somewhere. I can ask for money, but I won't. I will do that. Oh god, Archbishop. With my mother. Oh shit. Alright, so right now we're in a Confederate partition. So under Confederate partition, your titles will be divided equally between your children. New titles may be created for younger realm heirs. Under partition succession, your titles will be divided equally between your children. That doesn't change much of anything to me. Player heir gets plus 10. Now, what I want is this. So I guess we're gonna keep doing what we did, and we're just gonna wait for that to happen. Which should be soon. In 24 years, I'll probably be dead. And so the kingdom is once again going to be separated between all of these dudes. And then under Prince Louis of France, these are going to start being given to only one children. Let's find her a spouse. She's my daughter. She's intelligent, comely. No one. Let's look for handsome then. And probably for alliance power as well. Tuscany. He's still just a child. Humble, zealous, and just. Nikolaos Orphanotronos. And we can get it matrilineal, and we will do that. There you go. I don't know who these guys are. Oh, they are pretty far. Oh, that's this guy. Oh, by the way, I wonder where my dynasty... whatever. I wonder where my dynasty is over here. Remember I had one of my grandson that was... that was living around here. He was actually the head of the Byzantine Empire for a while before being deposed. I don't know where this guy went. Let's check it out. Let's look at the dynasty tree. I think he was Princess Ermengarde's son. Was it Duke Lambert? Was he the one? Duke Lambert? Yeah, I think he was the one. He's currently in Spoleto. Whatever, I don't know where that is. County of Spoleto. Oh, wow. He's over here now. Under the Byzantine Empire, they sent him all across here, which is pretty cool. Right beside the Papal, right beside Rome, you know, in the old Roman Empire provinces. So, all right. This is where Duke Lambert is. Alright, well, alright. It is what it is. Okay, guys. This is where... What happened here? Aquitaine actually fought war against the dude we didn't like. And they conquered his land. This is troublesome. This is very troublesome. Let's send gift to him and see if we can vassalize him. No, he will not accept, but we'll still try. And then we can sway him. Anyway, it kind of sucks. I mean, we do have claims here, so there you go. It would be quite the war, though, but, you know, I really don't like it when this guy takes control of the middle of my land. Okay, guys, well, we're gonna end it here. Under King Louis, we've taken back all of Wessex and more. We will try to gain more of these lands here if we can. We've taken back a little bit of grounds here and here, and our next goal should be to, you know, probably take back this little bits of land. I don't have anything against King Louis VI of Aquitaine, but these are my lands after all. And this is what we're gonna aim to do, and we're gonna also aim to finish construction and start to give our men at arms some bonuses to create some good armies for the future to defend ourselves. Thank you everyone for watching. I'll see you next episode. Goodbye.